Good morning and blessings to each one of you. Today we look into the theme, Jesus, the Bread of Life. And the reading will be from John 6. Let us draw closer to God with a call to worship based on John 6 verse 35. Jesus said, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry. Whoever comes to Christ will never be thirsty. Lord, give us this bread always. May we come to God with hungry hearts. May we come to Jesus with thirsty souls. May we find fulfillment in the body of Christ. May we worship God, knowing the fullness of God's love for us. This is who our Lord is, a God of love, a God who really gave his all. And in knowing that, let us enter into a time of confession. God of all, we come to you with broken hearts. We confess to you that we have sinned. We have broken faith with one another and with you. Our hearts have been led astray by the promises of this world. We have failed to live into your intention for our lives. We have failed to view your image in one another. We have taken what we wanted and taken it for granted and have harmed others in the process. Forgive us. Refine us and purify us, so that our hearts might heal and be filled with your love for one another. Remove the stains of the world that blister and fester, that lie to us about our needs and confuse them with our desires. Restore us fully to you, O God, and help us to seek forgiveness, reparation, and restoration wherever possible. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. A reading from John 6 is from verse 24 to verse 35. Verse 24. Once the crowd realized that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they got into the boat and went to Capernaum to search for Jesus. When they found him on the other side of the lake, they asked him, Rabbi, when did you get here? Jesus answered, I tell you the truth. You are looking for me, not because you saw miraculous signs, but because you ate the loaves and had your fill. Do not work for food that spoils, but for food that endures to eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. On him God the Father has placed his seal of approval. Then they ask him, What must we do to do the work God requires? Jesus answered, The work of God is this, to believe in the one he has sent. So they ask him, What miraculous sign then will you give that we may see it and believe you? What will you do? Our forefathers ate the manna in the desert. As it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat. Jesus said to them, I tell you the truth, it is not Moses who has given you the bread from heaven, but it is my Father who gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is he who comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. Sir, they said, from now on, give us this bread. Then Jesus declared, I am the bread of life. He who comes to me will never go hungry. And he who believes in me will never be thirsty. We read up to here and praise God for the word that is before us. In our reading of this week, the reading is from John's Gospel, where John brings to us the teaching of the bread of life. One thing that immediately drew my attention is a repetitive line in John 6. The line, "I am the bread of life." When this happens in Scripture, it is saying that this which is repeated is very important, especially if you keep in mind that in the original script, they could not use copy and paste as we do today. So every word had to be written out separately and therefore must have been very important. Picking up from last week's passage, the crowd went looking for Jesus after the feeding of the 5,000. Jesus had gone across the lake with the disciples after walking on the water to meet them. But then the crowds followed them on boats to Capernaum. Jesus knew they were looking for him because they wanted more bread, more physical and tangible ways of satisfying their needs. What do we want from the Lord? Is a question I think each one of us need to answer for ourselves. It is a question that we really need to unpack and analyze for ourselves. Jesus, instead of feeding them again, called the crowds to work for spiritual food, that which nourish for eternal life. Questions followed from the people, because they didn't completely understood. They did not receive what they came for. But now the crowds wanted to know what they must do to perform the work of God. It is strange but interesting to see Jesus and the way he responded. Jesus answered and said the work was to believe in the one God sent to them, meaning Jesus. Not completely satisfied, the crowd then asked for a sign. And one of them remembered the sign of manna in the wilderness from Moses. And Jesus corrected him. The manna was not from Moses, but from God. For God's bread gives life. And that is what he gave to us, Jesus, the bread of life. The crowds asked for Jesus to give them that bread, and, in a way, echoed the request from the Samaritan woman at the well who asked for the water of life, as you will see in John 4, verse 15. Jesus responded that he was the bread of life, and whoever came to him would never be hungry, and whoever believed in him would never be thirsty. And that is true for each one of us. But still the question remains, what is it that we are pursuing in life? What is it that we have added priority to in this life? Are we satisfied with what we have? Or are we pursuing more simply to gain more? What is the cost? Not financially, but spiritually, emotionally, and physically to us when we continue to just seek for more. Even when we believe we are trying to meet our daily needs, are we so caught up in the rat race or in keeping up with the Joneses that we miss what God desires for us? Are we all scavenging for bread instead of sharing the bread that we have with all those in need so that all people's needs can be met? We need to recognize that we are called to share and contribute to those we encounter and make a difference in this world. Then there will be enough for all, and then we will be living a life worth living. When the crowds in John's account followed Jesus because they wanted more bread, they were missing the point. The bread is already with them if they have Jesus. For in knowing Jesus, the soul is fed, and life is and will be complete. This is the bread of life. For whoever comes to Jesus and lives in Christ's ways will never be hungry or thirsty. That is what is most important. Amen. Loving Father, Saviour and Spirit, refresh us to really show your image. Remind us that we are made to create, to do your work in this world, to share beauty and awe. The ways of this world desire for us to produce, which is not the same as creativity, for creativity is breathed from you, loving Spirit. Creativity inspires others and always reminds us of your loving and your love in this world. Turn us away from the wheels of the world's production and into the gentle movement of your creativity in how we live, how we move, and how we exist and care for those around us. Father God, help us to really be open to your purpose for our lives, to live according to that, and to follow in your footsteps. In Jesus' name, Amen.